In other news, neighbors still raising more questions about last week's drowning in the Godley Park area.
It's a story we've been following all week. They're concerned because there's a fire station a half mile away, but those firefighters were never called to respond to this drowning. Our own Rob Mackle is working for you tonight with the latest. Rob?
Well, Kevin and Jennifer, last night we told you about the confusion about the neighborhood's location and how it affected the response time. Today, neighbors are asking why firefighters 2 minutes away didn't respond. Now, the Godley Park Fire Station is located on Highlands Boulevard, a half mile away from the Godley Park neighborhood, where four-year-old King Frazier drowned in the pool last Friday afternoon. We finally got the police report today. A witness says the boy hit his head against the swimming pool wall and that his mother pulled him out of the water. The report says a pediatric nurse was doing CPR on Frazier when police arrived. It took EMS crews 16 minutes to get to the boy because of the initial confusion over where the pool was located. Now, the Savannah Fire Station up the road was never dispatched because they do not respond to medical calls. Norm Madison lives in the Highlands area. He worked in public safety for 25 years in Michigan. He thinks that Savannah Fire should have been called to the drowning.
It's an attitude somewhere within the city not to respond to EMS calls. Basic EMS response, for the most part, is pretty standard. Most fire departments do respond to basic EMS. In this particular case, it's just unfortunate that a child had to drown with a fire station 2 minutes away from the pool.
City leaders would not do an on-camera interview about this. The city spokesman says police and firefighters are trained in CPR. He says Savannah Fire responds to fires, active water rescues, and car accidents. Emergency medical services are provided by Chatham County, which uses Southside Fire and EMS. Now, previously in the past year, Alderman Van Johnson has approached the city manager about having Savannah firefighters get EMS training, but he refused to do an interview with WJCL. We have once again requested the 911 tapes and the dispatch log, but haven't received them yet. Rob Mackle, WJCL News, working for you.